Hey, my name is Brian from LEWITT, and today we're going to be doing a tour of The Record Co., a nonprofit recording and rehearsal facility in South Boston.
This is awesome. So yeah, for vocal tracking, I mean, having the Avalon or the LA610 are great options.
They have a variety of professional studio spaces, production suites, and rehearsal rooms that have incredibly affordable rates.
Everybody learns a lot when they put a new microphone they haven't used before up on a stand.
It has a belief that music making is for everyone, and they are packed with a bunch of industry-leading gear, outboard gear, and microphones, including a bunch of the LEWITT microphones, which can be checked out for free with booked studio time.
Do you have any favorite cool pieces as an audio engineer yourself?
So what is a nonprofit recording studio? How does that even work? Let's go find out.
All right, we're in Studio B at The Record Co., and I'm sitting down with Matt, who is the founder and executive director here. And we're just going to talk a little bit about the mission of this space. And I guess, first of all, I wanted to ask what does it mean to be a nonprofit recording and rehearsal facility? And how does that operate differently from, you know, a commercial studio or a commercial practice space?
As a nonprofit, we're not owned by anybody. And so I would say the biggest difference is that the space is a community resource. It belongs to everyone. The work here is not to, you know, control or own the space. It's to provide a resource that anyone can use. And we, you know, facilitate the art of other people and the creativity of other people. So I would say there's a lot of, especially that creative facilitation is very much something that you would see in a commercial studio too. But it's, you know, it's about it being essentially a public park for music making or a community center, but instead of a pool, we have a bunch of recording studios.
Yeah, I love that. I'm here with Bobby Boyd.
How are you?
Good to meet you.
Thank you.
Awesome. Yeah, thanks for having me to the space to do a tour. So this is the check-in area here.
Yeah, this is the check-in. We have our reception area right here. And when guests come into the building, they check in with the reservations. We just make sure they check in the building so we have a head count of how many people are in the building. And then we get them off to their rooms.
Yeah, yeah, that's awesome.
Definitely.
So the first space that we're going to head to is Studio A. Is that
right? We can take a peek at Studio A, see what you think.
Cool. Yeah, let's check it out.
All right, check it out. Studio A is actually one of the bigger studios in the building.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So this would be like the premiere space for like a full band tracking session.
So this is the control room here. So we got an analog and a digital setup in here.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you got the hybrid thing going with the console.
Yeah, we got the hybrid thing in here. And this is just an amazing room. A lot of folks come into this space and they use it for events, but also recording. So you'll get bigger ensembles in here. Some of the conservatory students and some of the Berkeley students will actually come in here and use the space and pack it up.
And how many people are using the actual console kind of workflow?
It's mixed. Yeah. You'll have some old school folks that love the analog console, but then a lot of folks are using the digital consoles.
Yeah, and I think I read on your website you have like a sort of bring your own engineer kind of approach, which is interesting. Like, how do you, like, if I'm a freelance, you know, recording engineer, how would I be able to use this space?
Yeah, great question. So how you would be able to use this space is you would go to our TRC Facebook group. It's TRC Network, and you could actually go there if you didn't have an engineer. You could go there, find an engineer. But if you were an engineer and you wanted to come and use this space, you would just reach out to us on our website, and you'd have to do a quick little engineer orientation. It was about a 20-minute Zoom call. We just kind of walk you through the experience of what the gear is and kind of where everything is. Mm-hmm. And once you go through that, you're a registered engineer, and then you can start doing sessions here.
Oh, that's amazing.
Yeah.
Awesome. So it looks like there's even more over here.
There's a whole bunch.
So this, it's kind of like some master bus EQ kind of stuff with the warm audio, Pultec style EQs.
Yeah, they got a good setup in here.
Well, I've got a couple distressors. LA4s, you don't see those super often. That's cool.
Yeah.
Let's go check out the main recording space.
Absolutely. And then this is just the open space. So again, a lot of folks will use this space for events or, you know, we've had a lot of events here, you know, lately. open mic sessions or listening parties and things of that nature. So folks have been using it a lot of different ways since we've actually opened the space.
Yeah.
So it's been really, really
cool. this is a really cool room. I mean, I imagine it would be fun to do drums in here if you want a really big kind of room sound, but there's also a ton of different isolation booths, like you said, if you wanted to do live tracking and have everyone a little bit more isolated and whatnot. Looks like you got a piano over here as well.
Piano over there, yep.
There we go. So this is a Yamaha.
Go ahead, knock it out.
There you go. There's a C. That's all you get.
That's all you get. Hey, that's good.
I'm not much of a piano player. I'm more of a guitar player.
It's all good. You got me beat.
There you go. Are you an artist? Do you play music?
So
do you
perform? I don't play anything. I write a lot of music, and I did a lot of hip-hop music in the past, and I still write a lot. Writing, for me, is just a good release.
Yeah.
So all the stresses in life and all the challenges is just one of those ways that I release. So coming to TRC was like a full circle for me. I grew up in this neighborhood, and I remember going to recording studios when it was like $200 to $300 an hour.
Yeah.
So I was like, wow, you know, you get your first hour in, you save up all your little pennies, and then you get your first hour in, you're setting up for about the first 20 minutes, and by the time you get ready, it's all over.
Yeah, an hour is nothing. It's like, you know, especially if you're doing something like drums, like you can spend 4 hours setting up and tuning drums and getting everything set. So, definitely.
Yeah, so
having, I think you said $135 an hour for the
So for this
here?
Room, it's 130.
130.
For 4 hours.
For 4 hours.
For
oh, dang. Yeah.
So
that's
like
quite a bit more.
You can get
accessible.
A lot done.
Yeah.
You can get a lot done. So
that's great.
I really love the accessibility that TRC provides to folks, and the thing that I really enjoy seeing is all the young people that get to come in here.
Yeah.
And you see them, and they're in the production suites, and they're doing their thing, and you're like, I'm glad to see them in here, and they're not on the streets.
Yeah.
So that's really cool. So
yeah, that's amazing. Yeah. What sort of like projects do you get coming through here? Like who's coming here to record and rehearse? Like, you know, what does the clientele look like?
I wish I could tell you all of their names and faces and projects, but the truth is that in the 20 rooms we have here in this 12,500 square foot facility, we host about 900 reservations a month for 2,500 visitors.
Yeah, that's
so
awesome.
There's a lot happening here. You know, rough cuts, it's about 30% hip hop, another 25 to 30% rock, and then you know, the balance is 10, 12 other things, including I think a very healthy slug for other, because you know, don't put me in a box.
Sure.
Man. Yeah. So you know, we have a very wide spectrum of sort of career orientations or levels of experience, and sometimes it's a 15-year-old that's just exploring all of this for the first time and just, you know, kind of in here trying to figure out what button does what.
Yeah.
And then other times it's someone who, you know, makes 100% of their living as a music maker or as a technician.
Yeah. So these are smaller studios. Okay.
A lot of the studios, all of the studios here have similar equipment. So you're not going to miss out on too much. You're just going to have a difference in size.
Okay.
So this is Studio D. This is really comfortable. You come in here again, you can bring your own laptop and plug in, but we have everything set up for you in here.
Yeah.
And
your DAW of choice ready to
go. DAW of choice, you know, Pro Tools, Ableton, you know, the whole gambit. We have them all. And it's just really comfortable. This is actually one of my favorite rooms. I just love the setup, and you're kind of like,
it's cozy for sure. Yeah.
You know, out of the space. And then you got your isolation booth over here as well.
You mentioned, I know out here there's a rack of outboard gear. You mentioned a lot of these spaces have pretty similar gear.
Yep.
This is awesome. So yeah, for vocal tracking, I mean, having the
Avalon
or the LA-610 are great options there. That's sweet.
Yeah.
Distressor, it's classic.
Sorry, you can see all the gear you get here. So you got
guitars. Okay, so this is all backline for the studios?
This is all backline, and this is all open season. So you see a piece of gear that you need. You want to take it in your room, you just ask that you put it back.
Yeah, it's not like an extra rental charge. No. You just kind of, if it's available, you can reserve it.
Some beautiful ARPs over here, you know?
Oh yeah, so many cool keyboards. I love like the synth collection, you know, you have all your basses covered with your Strats and Teles, P basses, some acoustics.
So to the left here is our tech shop.
Okay, so they do repairs, as well as you guys have like floating gear too, right?
Yeah. Carlito.
Hey, what's up?
Say hello.
Hello.
This is Carlito. He is one of our most valued staff members here.
Yeah.
Very smart gentleman. Has a new album coming out.
Oh, yeah?
I do. Bobby's my best spokesperson.
February 11th.
It's an instrumental installation, yeah.
Called Beats Hotel. Yeah. Check it out, everybody.
Beats Hotel, February 10th. This is going to be out.
I am our staff's biggest fan. So all of our staff are artists. So I embarrass them a lot, and I always go around telling everybody about their projects.
Yeah.
I'm like, this project's coming out. You got to go check it out. This project. So yeah, I'm definitely that guy.
The floating gear is kept back here, I see.
Yeah. So we have like a bunch of microphones pretty much over here is like where all the mics live.
There we go. We got some LEWITT stuff right here.
Here we go. Yeah. So we just got.
We got the 640 TS. Yeah. There we
and
go.
Yeah, we got
540S.
Yep, some good ones, yeah.
Love it. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Love this one.
I love
one.
This guy.
640TS.
Yeah,
got the dual
good.
Output mode so you can record in stereo.
Mm-hmm.
So all this stuff, kind of like the backline in the hallway, is like you can just reserve it if you have a session booked and be like, hey, I'd love to use this microphone or
right.
this, you know, compressor.
And then like you were saying with the outboard gear, we have, some...
Some 1176.
Over here. Yeah.
Do you have any favorite cool. pieces as an audio engineer yourself?
I feel like the Avalon has been a part of my journey for years.
Yeah.
So like that's one of my go-tos, but like I'm really becoming a big fan of like the warm audio stuff.
Yeah. So vocal chain for you might be Avalon to warm audio 76.
Yeah exactly, definitely. Yeah.
Kind of looking at your mission on your website, I think it said something around like removing technical and social barriers for people to be able to create art, right, and make music. And I was curious to ask, with that mission, like how does this space accomplish that?
It's a good question. There's a lot of different barriers to people being creative and making music. There's a couple that we're really zeroed in on right now, but certainly it's not, our thinking isn't exclusive to those, but the big ones are physical space. So in a super expensive, super dense city, you can't play. It's hard to afford space to create, and in many cases, as a musician, you need some space that's outside of your home because you can't play drum set at 1 a.m. in your apartment.
You could, but it wouldn't go well.
Yeah, you could, but you would hear about it. So there's this very kind of physical, very specific thing where it's like I need somewhere I can make noise, and in a city it's hard to find those kinds of places. There's the issue of affordability of whatever that second space is, right? Mm-hmm. Artists and creatives have a hard enough time affording their rent, a place to live, let alone rent on a separate space to work.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's a lot of things related to cultural competence and racial and gender equity that are baked into, really deeply baked into the music industry and the recording industry that make these kinds of spaces traditionally inaccessible. Mm. And they put up a higher barrier for music makers of color, they put up a higher barrier for women and non-binary music makers. And so that's, in addition to making the physical space affordable, there's also this, frankly, much more challenging issue of making the space culturally competent and welcoming for people with a diversity of gender and racial group identities.
Yeah, no, that's huge. That's really cool that you guys are addressing both of those factors. And I am curious, so you guys do have a lot more affordable rates than you would see at most spaces. And and how does that work? That's subsidized by, different partners you have, or how does that, do you guys do fundraising efforts?
We do.
Yeah.
So then that's a huge part of my job as the executive director, really any nonprofit leader, fundraising to financially support the mission is critical. It's a critical part of my job. We have a lot of very generous donors, foundations, individuals, institutional partners who help to make this space, help to sustain this space, and help to keep it affordable for everybody. Our thinking about that, other than the actual act or the need to raise that money in order to keep it affordable, our thinking about the way that affordability functions in the marketplace is that this is a place where this is a space where you can make, recording zero, and then recording one, and then recording two. And by the time you've made recording two and you're going on to project three, four, five, you may be at a place where you want to start exploring other facilities or other, you know, with different technical capabilities. You may want to start exploring a facility that, unlike ours, has a staff of recording engineers and producers to help.
Sure.
You know, because those human beings, at the end of the day, are the thing that's really going to make the difference.
Mm-hmm.
So this is a very sort of self-service. You know, you get this room and you get the equipment. If I keep going with the pool metaphor right there, we have some lifeguards running around. If you get yourself into the deep end and somebody needs to pull you out of the pool, like, we'll help pull you out. But we're not actually teaching you how to swim.
Mm-hmm.
We're not trying
to bring your own swim instructor.
Yeah, we're not perfect. We're not trying to, you know, make you into a championship swimmer. We're not here to tell you why you're in the pool.
So next, maybe Studio B?
Yeah, this place.
So besides A, this is kind of the best spot if you wanted to a full band tracking session or something.
I think out of all the studios, this is probably the favorite of users.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I think most users would prefer to be in Studio B. I think it's just the layout. It's really comfortable, and there's more than enough space to do what you got to do in here.
Looks like this is a little bit more equipped when it comes to
a little bit
preamps and compressors and all that.
Yeah, just a little bit more equipment than
with a germanium compressor. That's sweet. We got the bus comp, a lot more pre options here.
Mm-hmm.
And then the DAW workflow. So A is the only one that has like an analog console, if that's your vibe, if that you want to work with
that. More folks get in here and you'll see the mic setups get crazy. You can get like 20 or 30 mics going on a drum set or whatever they got going in here. So we've had folks use this room for a whole host of different things. The meditation bowls were, this lady was in here with the meditation bowls most recently, and I thought that was really interesting.
Yeah,
how they mic those up
super
and
cool.
Create those sounds.
Meditation bowls, bagpipes, you guys see
you see it all.
Variety.
Yeah, you see it all.
No, I appreciate that you guys definitely put work into making it a kind of unique and cozy aesthetic, not just, you know, the bare minimum with treatment on the walls, but the funky wallpaper, the little touches here and there.
That's really important to the style of TRC. Like I said, the little trinkets, the things that you'll see, it's like, it's really, it all kind of marries together.
Yeah.
The whimsical
kind of.
It's
a space for artists, not necessarily just for technical people, you know.
Yeah.
You guys do production suites, but also have rehearsal rooms. So
absolutely.
I'd love to see an example of both of those.
Yeah. So these are some of the smaller rehearsal rooms here.
Oh, okay.
So this is like,
take a peek in here. Oh, there's a drum set. So
what we'll have happen here is that a lot of folks will come in here, individual, you know, like I said, you can rent a room, work on your craft, but we have a lot of music teachers that will come in here and rent these rooms. They're like 10 bucks an hour, and they'll bring their students here because all the gear's here. So we have three of those small little rehearsal rooms, and then we have six medium and two large.
Okay.
So this is one of the medium ones here.
Nice, and they all come equipped with a drum kit and amps and...
So you can request the room how you would like it.
Okay.
So most of the rooms will come with the drum kit already set up. You get your PA system in here, you get a couple amps, keyboard, mic stands, and then we get whatever setup you want in here.
All right, so this is where the seven-piece band should be practicing.
Yeah, this is where they should be. And this room gets up to about, you know, seven plus folks will come in here, depending on what they're playing.
Yeah.
And they can pack this room up and have at it. The accessibility is really, really important. Making sure that folks can get in here and have the time to put into their craft.
Yeah.
And not feel rushed, like, oh, it's so expensive.
The bagpipes.
There you go.
There we go. I've heard about these bagpipes, now we get to
experience. Now you get to experience, right? Yeah, so this is back out reception. That's one of the cooler pieces that Matt just put up.
Okay.
That came from an old shop, and it's a bingo board that he actually put new lights in. That's all programmable.
Oh, cool.
So we can change the colors. He did a great job with that. So this is a medium production suite.
Oh, nice, yeah.
So just a little bit more room.
Got the couch here, too.
Lounge area, you know?
Ooh.
Come in here, have a seat.
Cozy. Yeah.
You know? Go get yourself some free coffee.
Free coffee?
Free tea.
Dude, I'm sold.
Yeah.
I'm here.
You know? It's a community. Like, it's truly a community. Community of musicians, community of creatives, and it's growing. And it's amazing.
That's super cool. And you said there's a Facebook group. So if people wanted to find collaborators, whether it's an engineer or another musician, they can use that.
This TRC network.
TRC network.
Yeah.
Definitely resonate with kind of what you guys are doing and are grateful even just like in a very small way to be able to partner with you guys and, you know, offer up some LEWITT mics for the floating gear room and stuff for people to try out as they're here checking out the space. So.
And the feeling's mutual. I know that the, you know, 2,500 folks that are using this space every month are getting a lot of good use out of the mics and are, you know, no doubt learning a lot when they, everybody learns a lot when they put a new microphone they haven't used before up on a stand and push up a fader and have a listen. So I'm grateful for your support too.
All right, thank you so much for watching this video and a huge thanks to the team at The Record Co. for showing us around today. I hope you enjoyed this. If you did, let us know down in the comments if you want to see more content like this in the future. Also, feel free to let us know if you have any questions about The Record Co. and we'll do our best to answer them. Make yourself heard.